Hey everybody, what's going on? San Diego's favorite son, and we're gonna have a little fun today, or tonight. Right now, we're gonna make a pizza part deux. Now, we got a lot of great comments. MJ was a part of it, he was making it happen, but we're gonna get into the nitty gritty. We're gonna show you some of the various little tricks of our trade of how to make a pretty fun pizza. Because of the fact that my wife is a celiac, we actually are doing gluten-free. Turns out amazing. She really does an awesome job. So, hi, how are you?
Hi.
Okay, so we are going to take a look at what we've got going here. The celery is not for the pizza. This was a frozen pizza that we had. We were kind of comparing, but we're gonna do a little bit of mushrooms, onions, some linguica. Of course, we're going to be digging into that because that's how we roll. Going into a little bit of garlic sauce, and then going into, of course, our dough. One of the things that you're going to notice is that we combine, especially when we want to be quick because of the fact that it's already late and we need to get dinner going. We like to kind of do a combination between things that, you know, just straight up. For example, garlic, some of it will be out of a jar. And although I would always suggest utilizing fresh garlic or any fresh contents when you have a chance. So, all right, we're gonna get things ready right now. We're gonna get into the next step here in a couple seconds. Of course, you've got Frank in the back, and hopefully by then we'll have a glass poured and ready to rock. Okay, so what we're gonna do right now is we actually have some butter. It's always better with butter. What we're gonna do is we're gonna melt some of this truffle oil that we mixed into the butter, and we're gonna put that along the crust. My wife had a great idea as far as that going. But before we go too much further, I told you that we would be kicking it to the next level. We've gotta get this going. I mean, who does this, right? You gotta have a little bit of vino.
Have some wine.
Get that going. Have a little coppola in honor of my Italian brothers and sisters. And we'll do that. And by the way, excuse me, I got Corona.
The Rona. It's not funny.
I can't help it. It's my favorite beer. So, cheers to everybody.
Cheers.
Boom. Okay. Okay. So, we're going to go ahead and get that going. That'll be in a little bit. We're going to come right here. We're going to go right into some onions. Because, you know, I happen to love the combination between anything Portuguese and onions. So that if you want to look at any comedy videos of and ask your favorite Portuguese person, there are so many things. Everything we do is with onions. It's ridiculous.
Look up the Portuguese kid.
Yeah, the Portuguese kid, classic. What do we got right here? We've got linguiça. Linguiça, we all know, is Portuguese sausage. We're gonna get right into that. I just always feel like the more the better. And we always have some on hand. I'm not stabbing everything and making a mess. We're gonna get into that. By the way, my favorite, not only gluten-free pizza, and I've been coming somewhat of a professional on this, is besides my favorite pizza, is the Venetian. Big shout out to the Giacalone family who actually sold it, but big shout out. Happens to be my favorite Italian pizza in San Diego that I'm aware of. I think they've been around since, God, the 60s. And I know my family has always gone there since we were little. I mean, it's definitely a feat. And that's the first place that I had actually linguiça on a pizza, which is pretty amazing. So I think we've got enough of that. I'm making a mess, but that's just kind of how I roll. Over here, if you could take a look, we just went ahead and bought pizza sauce. Just use it as a foundation. Make life easy on yourself. Life is tough enough. We're gonna get into some garlic. Now, my opinion on the garlic is you can go ahead and put a little bit in your sauce, which is great. And then I put it on the base of the pizza itself, along with the oil, or maybe I'll do some olive oil, so you'll see that a little bit later. But I think that the sauce and the base is key, and that's one of the things, if I think of all great pizzas, it's all about the sauce. It's all about the sauce. You can tell I'm not Italian. But anyway, great stuff right there. And then, of course, we're going to go right into another thing that I think is awesome. You can do pretty much anything that you want. And that's, let's go ahead and let's get some mushrooms, right? So we're rocking and rolling. We're just going to go ahead and put these out here. Sometimes they get a little thick, so I just help a little bit. No big deal. Not a big deal. Not a big deal at all. We'll do a couple more, and then we should be good to go. Okay, but again, when I'm looking at a base, I always feel like it needs everything, a little bit of love, a little bit going in here. I like things strong, and then I'm gonna come on over here. I'm gonna do a little garlic salt. Thank God for the Costco version right inside there. And then lastly, I like to do a little extra garlic. Got them really on the case right now. And throw a little bit right there. So, yeah, this is, no, I'm not playing around. But then again, I'm married, so I could do this. I'm not going on any dates. All right. So that's what we're doing. We're just going to continue to let this, we're not looking for it to cook, but I do like to see it. I do like to see it get a little bit warm and activate all the ingredients. Mm. Okay, one of the other things that I think are critical that I put on is Italian seasoning. Oregano is a great, is would be enough, but I think Italian seasoning gives it a little bit more character. I don't know, it's not bad. All right, so now we've got those main ingredients. Like I said, we've got tons of cheese that we've already cut up. You got this here, and you know what? I'm a believer of whatever you got in your fridge, you know, screw it. Just cut it up. We got a little Colby, a little mozzarella, because that's what we have. I've tried a lot of dairy-free cheese because I'm lactose intolerant. But they just don't do it. They just don't do it. Nobody does. A couple other things that I like to throw on there. Of course, you could do a little bit of pepperoni, but I just think that'll just take away from linguica. And then if you wanted to do any prosciutto or something like that, although again, I think that might be taking, you know, the linguica will take away from it. That might be better with going a completely different presentation. One of the other things I love is ricotta cheese. I love ricotta cheese in my pizzas. So we'll do all that in a little bit. But right now, we're just gonna take a little time out and keep drinking because, you know, we're good at that. Our neighbor is so amazing. We actually got, yes, you are gonna be super jelly because we got a shipment from back east of fresh oysters as well as clams. So we're gonna take a little bit of break and show you kind of how to chuck an oyster. How much could a woodchuck chuck? A woodchuck
would chuck wood. Because it's a shuck, not a chuck.
No, it's a shuck, not a chuck, because nobody chucks anymore. Mm-mm. Quit chucking around. What I like to say. All right, so I don't have the appropriate knife, but if you did have a knife, you would want one a little bit thicker than this. As you can tell, I've already been using this one. Thicker, better, you know how that program is. You want to have the base right there. Usually what you want to do is you want to have some sort of a towel, which we're going to grab one. Thank you, my beautiful assistant. And you want to put your thumb kind of wrapped, excuse me, you want to wrap it like this. You want to have the chuck bottom half, the base right there, the big part on the bottom. And right here is, like we like to say, the tuchus. You want to start kind of dwindling into that little side right there. Okay, let's just make a little room here. And you want to start finding the corner piece, and you just want to work your way in there. And let's just see how lucky we are with this. And then once you get in, just like anything else, you want to make some stuff happen and slowly start working around the ribs. And such an evil bit. Okay, and then you have it. Boom, voila. We've got a little oyster that's ready to rock and be served. But like I said, these things are amazing, amazing. And we want to support our local people here that are doing just such a bravo job. We had a little bit of shallots, red wine vinegar. I'll do a little hot sauce, but because we're just here right now, I don't like to do cocktail sauce. I think it just hides the flavor, especially when something this fresh. I'm telling you, it came straight out yesterday. Here we go. Mmm. Oh my God. Ridiculous. And like I said, pretty good stuff. I'll make one for my wife real quick because I know she'll be down with it. We don't want to leave her out. Again, we're looking at this little hole right here, the little backside. Okay. Always protect. Put your hands underneath back there. You're going to do that a little bit here. And not the best tool in the world, but it's the tool I'm using because it's all I had right now. And I don't want to break any of my other knives. But we're just looking to get inside that. And then hopefully, in time.
Come on.
Baby, come on, for Ludman. For Canadian Lud, be in the hand. Okay. And here we go. We are not working. Okay.
She's a toughie.
Yeah, she's a toughie. You know what we're going to do because we're on TV and we all know about TV. We'll give it one more shot.
And then we'll move on.
But then we'll move on.
I'll get one later.
Yeah. Okay. All right. I'm so determined, but it's just really... Oh, here we go. Okay. And we got it. Just a little finicky, that one. No, no idea. Okay. Give it a little bit of love. Get a little bit here. Get it out. Okay, comes out. Look at that, baby.
Oh, beautiful.
So amazing.
Love you. Now, these are from the East Coast, right?
Yeah, these are from the East Coast. Usually they're a little bit smaller, but...
It's a little big.
A little big, but you know what? Yep. We like to call this baby-making music. All right. There you go, honey. Can you do that?
Mm-hmm.
All right. She's got that going. I promised her I wouldn't pull her on TV because... I surprised this whole idea on her, like, as we were setting up. So, all right, done. Now, we got sauce. We're going to go right into the next portion of looking at the pizza, having a little bit of fun. I did want to say props to, especially in gluten-free, because we don't always have time to flip and make our own dough. This stuff's pretty good. If you're a gluten-free fan, and again, I'm not, but for my family's sake, stuff's pretty good over at... Costco. And we're gonna go ahead and create, like I said, come on, get a little bit closer. And we're just gonna create a little bit of some kneading here. Try to go quickly. Now my wife does all the prepping, so I really need to give her credit. I just, the talent.
You just show up on camera.
Boom. But we're just creating little, just simple ridges.
And I will say the crust was really easy to make.
Yeah, what?
Flour, rapid rise yeast, all purpose, gluten free baking flour, rapid rise yeast, water, and a little bit of sugar to activate, and you're good to go.
Now, I noticed this is a little bit thinner. Is that going to be an issue as we.
You can just, again, you can just build that up. Again, this is organic. This is homemade. It doesn't need to be perfect, but you don't want a hole through your pizza.
No, nobody does that. And nobody has time for it either.
No.
Okay, so we're going to go right in there. And we're going to, first, so we talked about this truffle butter that we had right here. And...
frying pan for you.
Yes, it is. Okay. And we're going to take this, and we're just going to go right around the little edges that we created.
The crust is going to be... Turn it nice and golden brown and delicious.
Delicioso good, is what I'd like to say.
Mm-hmm.
And again, because this is pretty rich, you don't have to go out of control on this. You're just looking for a little bit of flavor. You could even put it on the pizza in the middle, but truffle strong. Yeah, truffle. You know, you don't want to overdo it. You've got a lot of other flavors here that are pretty strong. So, again, we're having fun. Love it. And, God, you just got to love
Frank.
Frank, baby. He just does it so well. All right, so now we're getting to the good part. This is the fun part. I personally love a little bit of oil all the time. All the time. It goes down smooth all the time. There we go. But I also think it helps with creating a little bit of continuity with the way everything's gonna cook here. So I just like to spread that around a little bit. You didn't have to, but it's just the way I like to do it. Okay, all right. I also am a fan of doing a little bit of, again, fresh garlic is always preferred, but in this case, we are just gonna just dab a little. Yeah, that just happened. Okay, but we're gonna do that right there. And again, we're just gonna take this same process here and just get that around. How good does that look? If you're not hungry right now, what are you doing? Don't answer that question.
Delicious.
Yeah, delicious. As my son says, it's delicious.
It's delicious.
Okay, so again, like anything else, I am a huge proponent of giving yourself a little bit right there. Boom. Now we're going to get into the next is that sauce, and I am not shy. Okay, let's see how we do here.
We definitely have a different way of making our pizzas.
Mm-hmm. This is killing her.
Right yep, now. It's this killing me.
Killing her, Smalls.
But,
she's killing her.
You know, it's his show right now.
Yeah, yeah. You know what? It is my show. All right. Come on. How is this not perfect? Okay. Groovy. Now, I happen to think one of the best, again, my favorite is I just throw linguica, just like you would pepperoni. Just get it out there. One of the other things we didn't have in the fridge, but big fans of you know, bell pepper. Bell pepper, and it's just so underrated.
Bell pepper on a pizza. Awesome.
So underrated. So underrated. And as you can tell, I like putting a lot.
Okay, wow.
That is.
I hope that crust can stand up to
this. Yeah. Oh, for cleaning. Okay. And then we just go with some onions. I probably did do a little bit over the top on that linguica, but you know what? It's my pizza. But I do agree with her. I think maybe this might have been a little bit too much. We'll just see. Same with the thing with the onions. Just kind of get that out there. As you can see, Alexa. There you go. My son. Look
hey,
at my
Sunday.
Son. Did you hear my son just pull it in? Okay. And then lastly, I am. Love my mushrooms. The key to anything, I think, is prep. Other people don't stress enough having all of this stuff already done, okay? And just all cut up and ready to rock, because it just makes it more fun. And then, again, okay. So then we are going to take this to another level, and we're gonna take this cheese right here, and we're just gonna, boom! Top of the heat! These Bantam blues are melting away. I mean, come on, it's pizza. Who doesn't put a lot of cheese? Okay, all right, it looks like we are just about done. So this is it. Okay, kids, now to the next thing. Really important is to make sure that you have enough flour on the sheet that you can slide this off, whether you're putting it on a cookie pan or if you have an actual pizza pan, which is the best because it cooks so evenly, but you've got to slide this on there. So it's really important that you have a ton of flour to be able to make that happen. And that flour's got to be there before you put your dough. So a little FYI. All right, we're now going to throw in the oven. Hang on, this. Boom, top of the heat.
Cheers.
Cheers, everybody. Love you. I hope you're safe. God, I miss you all. So we are ready for the big deal. All right. So this one was a little bit thicker. Usually it's about 12 minutes, but everything's variable. You know, I like a little more crust. This one probably took around 18 minutes, I think. Let's take a look at this bad boy. Boom. Yeah. That's the way. I like it. Okay. So be careful because this shot is warm. Get this over here. We're gonna make it real gentle. Okay, this is gonna be hot, so we're gonna move quick. Okay, and that's gonna allow that to cook a little bit more as we keep it on the pan. But I mean, honestly, just talking about the little stuff, that would be the big time right there in the background. He's super excited. You know what's great about what's going on right now? When we have something like this happening, we get the opportunity to create memories. The kitchen, the dining room table, wherever, your countertop. Food is the medium for us to all come together. Christian, Muslim, Jewish, and so forth. All of us have so many great milestones and important dates, and part of it is celebrates food. So, you know, I'm so glad that you were able to come out and spend a little time with me and my family. The next time, I think what we're going to do is we've got those mussels and clams. We're going to make some mussels and clams here tomorrow night. So, yeah, I love you all. Make it a great day.